Welcome to the Golden Valley Unified School District's California Physical Fitness Test training video, where we'll learn about how to measure your body composition, aerobic capacity, flexibility, upper body strength and endurance, abdominal strength and endurance, and your trunk extensor strength and flexibility.
Hi students, this is your PE testing card, and it's very important that you follow these directions to complete your PE testing successfully. All you will write on this is your name, first and last, and your room number. Everything else will be filled out by the proctors. Please don't put in your height or your weight, even if you know those items. We'll need to do that officially at the very end of all the testing. The other information here, as you do the mile run, push-ups, curl-ups, trunk lift, sit and reach, the information will be written in. Now on the shoulder stretch, you'll try that one before the sit and reach, and if you pass that, you won't need to do the sit and reach if you can do the shoulder stretch. So this card is very important. Don't lose it. Otherwise, you would have to redo those events. Good luck, Sunbirds.
One of the events of the physical fitness test is to measure your upper body strength and endurance. For this, we're going to be doing the push-up. The correct front-leaning rest position is as follows. Right? His back is nice and straight, and his arms are out in front of his chest. Now, your proctor will have a 3x5 card. On the command of down, the 3x5 card will touch the bicep, and he'll fully extend. At that point, you will receive one rep once you are fully extended. The push-up event will look like this. Front-leaning rest position. Ready? Begin. Down. One. Down. Two. Down. Three. Down. Four. Disqualified. Record three. In the push-up event, there are disqualifiers. At any point you commit one of these disqualifiers, your points will be tallied and written down on your scorecard. The disqualifiers look like this. Go ahead and go to the front-leaning rest position. The first one is if you lift any arm off the ground or foot off the ground, at that point you will be disqualified. Also, if you sag too much in the middle or arc and flex your back, at that point you will also be disqualified. The third disqualifier is if you're unable to perform two continuous repetitions within the cadence, you will be disqualified at that point as well. It will look like as follows. Down. Down, down, down. At any point you do commit any of those disqualifiers, either unable to do two correct push-ups within the cadence, flex or arc your back, or pick up your hand or foot, you will be disqualified. Now when that happens, your proctor will ask you to please get up and they will record your correct number of push-ups performed. So the next event is to test your flexibility. And this event is the shoulder stretch. So the proctor is gonna ask the next participant to step forward. And during that time, you're just gonna say to put your right hand over your left shoulder. Go ahead and turn around for me, right over left. And notice his fingers do touch. So now he's able to do the next one. Left over right, fingers do touch. So then he does pass. Now, at any instance, if a proctor does say right over left, you're good, and you do a left over right, and you're not able to make them touch, then that'll be a disqualifier, and then you'll have to do the sit in reach, which is our next event for flexibility.
The next way to test your flexibility is through the sit in reach. Make sure that you remove your shoes for this activity and stretch those hamstrings before. For the sit and reach, you'll be asked to take a seat on the ground. Your left leg will go first. We'll have it fully extended, and your foot will be pressed against the left side of the box. Your right foot will remain planted on the ground with your knee up. You'll be asked to put your hand on top of the other, your fingers lined up, great. And when you're ready, you will reach as far as you can. Great. You'll have another opportunity on the left side. Okay, and then we'll do the same thing on the right side. These are the common disqualifiers that many students make. The first would be to lift the leg that's extended. See how our knee went up? The second one would be to drop your alternate knee for a further reach. The third disqualifier would be to split your hands as you're reaching. And the fourth disqualifier would be if you drop your head as you're reaching. We want to make sure that our face remains parallel and we're looking straight ahead. For this next test, you will be participating in the trunk lift. The object of the trunk lift is to work your back muscles and see how far they can extend. So the participant will lay directly flat on the ground. You will tuck your hands underneath your thighs, just as so, and you will point your toes, okay? Your face will remain parallel to the floor. There will be a marker on the floor that you will stare at the entire time. When you are told to lift your head, you need to make sure that your chin is tucked and that your face remains parallel to the ground. You want to make sure that you're lifting slowly as to not hurt yourself. When the proctor says up, you will lift, hold, and when she says down, you can release. You will have two opportunities to do this test, and with the highest maximum being 12 inches. And this is what this test will look like when you do it. Come on in, lay directly on the ground. And up, down. One more try, up, down. Okay, and I will record it on their sheet. Thank you. And here are some ways not to do the exercise. The first one being moving too quickly. The second way would be to use your neck instead of your back muscles. And the third way would be to use your hands.
So here's the small rules in the curl up event. So first, before the command of up is given, your head needs to be on the ground. And your fingers also should be on this side of the furthest line, or if you're using a strip, on this side of the strip, cannot be over the strip. Now on the command of up, both hands must touch either the other side of the strip or the other line if you're using one of these mats, and you can go back down on your own. Another thing, when you're up, you cannot sway from side to side and only touch it with one hand or another. They both have to be done at the same time. And finally, the legs must maintain, your feet must maintain on the ground. You gotta be somewhere between 90 to 120 degrees max on this one as well. And then your hands also cannot come up off the ground. So this is what it's gonna look like when you're doing the curl up event. Go ahead and take a seat. Now she's taking a seat. If you have multiple students doing this at the same time, because it's an in-cadence event, only one proctor will be saying the command of up every 3 seconds, or you can use the FitnessGram CD and follow along. This proctor's ready, making sure all the other proctors are ready and everyone's ready before the event starts. Up. 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 Disqualified. At this time, your proctor will record your score on your card.
In the California Physical Fitness Test, one of the events is to measure cardiovascular endurance. During this test, you're gonna run 4 1/4 mile laps, and in which case, at no time, will you be able to help or hinder anyone else involved.
During the test, please make sure you keep your hands to yourself. You also don't wanna stop in front of anyone else. During the run, make sure that you're moving continuously. You don't want to stop along the way. And lastly, you want to make sure that you're not just talking to your friends.
Oh man. What are you gonna do later at the pool?
Oh, you wanna go swimming?
Yeah.
Okay, for this last component, we will be taking your height and your weight. The proctor will invite you in. You'll make sure your shoes are taken off and you'll step right on the scale with your back facing the scale. The proctor will take both your height and your weight and record it on your sheet. Okay, thank you. You'll be asked to step off. Make sure you take your card and turn it in.
Station number